Bring back rock.
Hey everybody, it's Dean and welcome to Bring Back Rock. It's time for another Top 20. Today we're talking about one of the most popular bands of the decade, Poison. Now I probably could have taken 8 songs off the first album, 8 songs off the second album, 4 songs off the third album and called the list done, but that just ignores too much of a great catalog. So here it is, the definitive 20 greatest Poison songs of all time.
Number 20. Sexual Thing.
Is your big nail some more? Where have I heard that before? I'm just a sexual thing.
At number 20, we have Sexual Thing from the shelved Crack a Smile record, featuring Blue Sarcino on guitar. Most of us got a taste of this in 1996 on the Poison's Greatest Hits record as one of the 2 new songs released. And unless you had a bootleg, you had to wait until 2000 to finally hear the Crack a Smile album. This was a really good song. Got me excited to hear the Crack a Smile album. 20, Sexual Thing.
Number 19.
No More Looking Back, Poison Jazz.
Wait.
We have No More Looking Back, Poison Jazz. Not sure what the Poison Jazz thing's all about. Anyway, this comes off of Swallow This Live, which came out in November. Now in September, on the MTV Video Awards, was when they had their big blow-up, which led to CC DeVille being ousted from the band, which is why you only see Bret Michaels in the video for the single that was off of that, Tell Me Why, which I thought was going to be here. But when I re-listened to the songs, I really dug the riff on this one. And that's why it comes in at number 19.
Number 18, Something to Believe In.
At number 18, we have the ballad Something to Believe In off of 1990's Flesh and Blood album. Flesh and Blood went to number 2 on the Billboard album chart. This single peaked at number 4 on the top 40 singles chart. This song was voted Song of the Year and Video of the Year for Metal Edge in 1990. At 18, Something to Believe In.
Give me something to believe in, that there's a Lord above. I give me something to believe in, oh Lord, arise. My best friend died.
Number 17, Back to the Rocking Horse.
In May of 1988, Poison released their sophomore record and their most successful album, Open Up and Say Ah, which went 5 times platinum and went to number 2 on the U.S. album charts. Part of the reason I love this album so much is because of how many deep cuts are on the album. So many songs I love that weren't singles, including this one, Back to the Rocking Horse at 17.
Number 16, Poor Boy Blues.
In my opinion, Flesh and Blood wasn't quite as strong as the first 2 albums top to bottom, but there were some deeper cuts that I loved, including this one at number 16, Poor Boy Blues.
Number 15, Want Some, need some.
Anybody, somebody, someone custom built for me. Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
Be all right.
Want Some, Need Some is the first song to make the list at number 15 off of Poison's debut album, Look What the Cat Dragged In, which came out in 1986, went triple platinum, and made it all the way to number 3 on the Billboard album charts.
Number 14, Ain't That the Truth?
This is the first song off of the album Native Tongue, which was released in February of 93. A change of style to more bluesy style, a change in guitarist from CC DeVille to Richie Kotzen, and a change in the music scene had this Poison's least successful album at the time. It still went gold in the US and number 16 on the album charts, and some of the songs still had that cool Poison feel, like this one, Ain't That the Truth, at number 14.
So her guy leaned closer, and this is what she said. Old man stands about 6'5", and if he catches you, you're dead. I don't need none of that giving me the blues. Until the old man sitting next to me said, so let me tell you, life you just can't fake it, love.
Number 13,
Strange.
In June of 2000, Poison released the live album Power to the People. It also included 5 studio tracks, including CC DeVille's first song on lead vocals, the hilariously titled I Hate Every Bone in Your Body But Mine, and I probably should have found a place on the list for that one. This album was also rebranded as Great Big Hits Live Bootleg and re-released in 2006. Minus the studio tracks, and minus the guitar and drum solo. The song I picked off of this album for the list, kind of a mid-tempo one, a little bit of a country feel, but I could really relate to the lyrics at the time, and it always gets me singing along, at number 13, Strange.
But I didn't think she'd want me, no. Right there she took me, underneath that sun, we became one, she said. That's a little strange. We all need a little strange sometimes. I'm a little strange. A lot like you. Let's ride.
Number 11, Strike Up the Band.
Yes, at number 12, we have the second entry from Poison's 1993 release, Native Tongue. This song could have fit in on any Poison album. It's got that party rock attitude, and it is called Strike Up the Band.
Number 13, Fallen Angel.
Cause sometimes she changes. It's like her head say wind. Tails you're gonna lose. Win big, mama's fallen angel. Lose big, living out of life. Once it all, mama's fallen angel. Lose it all, rolling the dice of her life. Now she found herself in the
All right, so at number 11, we have one of Poison's most popular songs. It went up to number 12 on the singles chart, and the video was everywhere. If you remember, the girl in the video was really hot. Happened to be Bret Michaels' girlfriend at the time, Susie Hatton, the model, actress, and singer who released her own album, Body and Soul, which was produced and co-written by Bret Michaels. Now let's see what we've got in the top 10.
Number 10, Let It Play.
Cold outside and the car won't stop.
number 10, one of my favorite songs, one of my favorite off of Flesh and Blood, a song about the positive power music can have on you mentally and emotionally, and it rocks. Let it play at number 10. Let's see what's at number 9.
Number 9, Love on the Rocks.
Why don't you swallow this?
Love on the rocks. Love on the rocks.
What can you say about Love at the Rocks at number 9? It's just a fun, cool, up-tempo song with a great riff and the perfect way to open up album number 2. Now let's see what's at number 8.
Number 8, Let Me Go to the Show.
So I got real sin, put out the biggest fight. Mama, let me go to the show. I dig them bad boys playing that rock and roll. Mama, let me go out tonight. Oh, mama, please, before I lose my mind.
Alright, the final song on the debut album, Look What the Cat Dragged In, comes in at number 8. Lyrically, who didn't have problems with their parents at one time or another when all you wanted to do was rock? And the way this song ends is the perfect way to wrap up the album. You know what I'm talking about. Alright, what's next?
Number 7, Every Rose Has Its Thorn.
Has it ever been like this? And I know that you would be here right now if I could have let you know somehow. I guess every rose has its thorn, just like every night has its dawn, just like
Okay, there it is at number 7, Poison's most famous song, Every Rose Has Its Thorn, which went all the way to number 1 on the Billboard single charts and sold over 500,000 copies, going gold. The video was filmed at Brown County Veterans Memorial Arena in Green Bay, Wisconsin, on the first night of their headlining tour supporting Open Up and Say Ah. As a matter of fact, Poison started every one of their tours at that arena in Green Bay, Wisconsin. And in 2019, for the final show at that arena, Bret Michaels was called into action once again because of his history with the place, and he headlined the final show at the arena. Pretty cool. All right, on to number 6.
Number 6, Look What the Cat Dragged In.
Poison had a well-earned reputation for being the ultimate party band, and this is a song about the morning after. It's one of my favorite songs off the debut album, and it gets me right away with that killer opening guitar riff. Look What the Cat Dragged In comes in at number 6. Now let's see who made the top 5.
Number 5, Unskinny Bop.
At 5, we have Unskinny Bop, which peaked at number 3 on the U.S. Billboard singles chart, and again, went gold, selling over 500,000 copies. It had a really catchy, cool bass groove at the beginning, and was a great opening single off of Flesh and Blood. The band at one time claimed that Unskinny Bop really didn't mean anything and just phonetically fit the song. However, on the song Home Off Hollyweird, we all know what Unskinny Bop means. It was slang for CC banging a porno queen. All right, let's get on to number four.
Number four, Living for the Minute.
Well, that's a surprise. Living for the Minute at number four. It was the B-side to the single For Every Rose Has Its Thorn, and me and my friends could not believe this song did not make the album. It is killer, and you did eventually get to hear it on the 20th anniversary remaster of Open Up and Say Ah as a bonus track. So Living for the Minute at number four. Let's see what's at number three.
Number three, Look But You Can't Touch.
What fun is that? Well, it's better than nothing.
Look But You Can't Touch comes in at number three. It's my favorite deep track off of Open Up and Say Ah. Eventually, the lyrics get to a point where it warns of the effect alcohol can have on your decision-making, a lesson many of us have had to learn repeatedly. What can I say? The song's catchy as hell. I love it. And it's at number three. Now let's check out the top two.
Number two, Nothing But a Good Time.
At number two, we have Nothing But a Good Time, the lead-off single for the Open Up and Say Ah album. It hit number six on the Billboard Hot 100 Singles chart. Something surprised me. A lot of these songs were higher on the Billboard charts than the mainstream rock charts. For example, this one only made it to number 16 on the rock charts. Either way, this song was great. The video was great. It pretty much summed up what Poison was all about. Nothing But a Good Time comes in at number two. Now let's see what took the number one spot.
Number one, Talk Dirty to Me.
There you go. Number one, Talk Dirty to Me, the song that introduced most of us to the band Poison. I know there was a video before that in Cry Tough, but the first video I ever saw was Talk Dirty to Me, and the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, summed it up. I believe he was talking to Ricky Rocket. He said, every time that video comes on, I stop and I watch the whole thing. You guys just look like you're having so much fun. He just wants to be there. And that is what it looked like. It looked like Poison was here to party and show you nothing but a good time. I remember I saw the video, ran, got the album immediately, played it for all my friends, turned them on to the band. This song went all the way to number 9 on the Billboard single chart and was the establishing video for making Poison one of the biggest bands of the decade. All right, that's it. That is undeniably the 20 greatest Poison songs of all time. All right, so that's the list. I expect some casual Poison fans to have some disagreements, as there are at least 6 singles that did not make the list. So please feel free to tell me what I got wrong down below. I want to say thank you to anybody who takes time to watch this and who spends time on the channel. I'd also like to say, if you want to make my day, hit that subscribe button like Steve Boy, Highlander 1612, Chris, and Wade, and also Aaron. Thank you very much, guys. I just want to mention Aaron. She has a podcast on Spotify called Manic Movie Monday. And if you grew up in the video stores like I did, you're going to find something to like on her podcast. My life was basically movies and music when I was growing up. So she just told me that she is doing her own episode of the Bikini Car Wash Company, probably in March of 23. If you've seen my episode, the music of the Bikini Car Wash Company movies, thank you. If not, go back and check it out, because you're going to hear about a couple of great bands you might not have heard of. And our own friend of the show, Todd Lane, if you've seen my interview with him, great, thank you, I appreciate it. If not, go back and check it out, because he told some great stories. It's really fun to talk to. And he may also be on Aaron's podcast, Manic Movie Monday, for the Bikini Car Wash Company episodes. I know they've been in contact. Hopefully it works out. So just wanted to mention all that. Once again, say thank you very much for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.